Hi there, and welcome to Dive Into Cloud Native, Containers, Kubernetes, and the KCNA exam. My name's James Spurrin, and I'm your instructor for this course. Cloud Native is one of the hottest topics in technology at the moment, covering a wide variety of areas. Exciting technologies such as containers and Kubernetes. Methodologies like Cloud Native Architecture, i.e. how you can design your applications with the likes of autoscaling and serverless. How you deliver your applications through GitOps and CI/CD pipelines, and how you can observe and monitor your infrastructure. This course covers all of these areas and more, and awareness of Cloud Native will help you excel in any career, whether you're an engineer, a developer, or a manager. Through this course, you'll gain a thorough understanding of Cloud Native, and you'll also be able to target the Kubernetes and Cloud Native Associate exam with confidence. You'll be learning how to use the same tools and approaches that are being used by the world's leading technology companies. We're talking about the likes of Google, Facebook, Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, and many more. And this isn't just a teaser with corporations to draw you in. These companies both extensively make use of Cloud Native to run their technology, and they also promote Cloud Native practices. And these are only a small subset of corporations that are actually following in this direction. These leading companies are able to operate efficiently on scale because they embrace Cloud Native. And you'll be learning the same approaches used by these tech giants. So, with that in mind, let's dive into the curriculum. This course is designed from first principles, and all you'll need is a basic knowledge of Linux. I'll be covering all topics in the exam related to this course in a manner that logically builds upon each previous lesson. Personally, I've completed the KCNA exam, and I'm confident that this course covers all major areas. Not only that, you'll be confident and successful using these skills in the real world. We're in section one right now, and in the remainder of this section, we'll learn what is Cloud Native, who are the Linux Foundation, and why are they important, what exactly is the CNCF, and how do I benefit from their efforts. We'll take a look at the KCNA, the Kubernetes and Cloud Native Associate Certification, and what's actually involved in achieving this. In section two, we'll be covering Cloud Native Architecture. We'll start with Cloud Native Fundamentals. We'll move on to Cloud Native Practices. Along the way, we'll also cover autoscaling, community and governance, serverless, personas, and open standards. From a certification viewpoint, this aligns to 16% of the KCNA curriculum. Next, one of my favorites, being a Docker captain, is containers. On the KCNA curriculum, 22% is for container orchestration. However, you can't really learn container orchestration without a good foundation of containers. So, in this one, we'll cover an introduction to containers, we'll install and configure Docker, we'll run containers and talk through different approaches for execution, and then we're going to do something really cool. And for this, we have a project where we'll be making a container that creates a matrix environment in your terminal. And we'll be building all of this from scratch. Along the way, we'll also cover other aspects relating to container security, which are especially important anyway, but are also part of the KCNA examination. Next up, an area I'm sure many of you are keen to get to, Kubernetes. Kubernetes is absolutely awesome, and in the KCNA exam, it accounts for 46% of the curriculum. There's so many topics in this that we'll be diving into, so architecture, distribution, container runtimes, pods, which are the smallest unit of compute in Kubernetes, namespaces, daemon sets, which allow you to run a pod on every node, services to access your applications, jobs, config maps, secrets, RBAC, role-based access control, labels, and much, much more. And if you don't know Kubernetes before starting this, you'll be confident by the end of it. And if this wasn't enough, these sections were just too big, so I actually split them into two. We continue with a Kubernetes deep dive, which continues to cover topics that are also part of the 46% of the curriculum. So this will include the Kubernetes API, scheduling, storage, stateful sets, network policies, pod disruption budgets, the Helm package manager, service meshes, and security. Next up is telemetry and observability. Whilst this is 8% of the curriculum, don't let that fool you. In my opinion, this and the next section are two of the most important ones that will probably help you the most in your career. Think about a company like the ones that we actually mentioned there, the Googles, the Netflix, the Amazons. How do they operate on scale with extremely high uptimes? Well, they have great telemetry and observability. Something I noticed at KubeCon, the main Kubernetes event of the year, talks in this area are now filling up quicker than many others as there's a huge demand for telemetry and observability. You'll see in this section how effective this can be. We're going to take a look at cloud native observability, Kubernetes login and what actual options you get natively with that, Prometheus and Grafana. And that last combo, Prometheus and Grafana, are absolutely incredible. And if you've not seen these before, you'll be blown away when you see them in action. Lastly, section 7, cloud native application delivery. Another one which is 8%, but as I say, again, don't overlook this. These are essential skills. Think of them as the scaffolding around your container orchestration. In this, we'll be covering application delivery fundamentals, GitOps, CI/CD, and we're also going to take a look at Argo, which is another one which is absolutely fantastic. So hopefully now you're excited about cloud native. If you're wondering who I am, here's a quick overview. Over 25 years experience that covers almost every area of technology. I've worked in financial services for some of the world's leading organizations. I'm an advocate of open source, and as well as my own projects, I'm a contributor to many projects, including Kubernetes, Docker, and Ansible. Lastly, before we go, I don't want you to just pass the KCNA exam. I've seen many people do this, and yet some still stumble when it comes to any practical, real-life experience. I want you to pass the exam and thoroughly know all of this in depth and for it to be able to be put to use in the best way for you, whatever your situation is. So, with that in mind, let's dive in.